गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू क्लास 8. मायसेल्फ मिस रजिया एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेटर राइटिंग. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एंड राइट हाउ टू राइट अ लेटर. सो स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल ऑफ यू गेट रेडी विथ योर इंग्लिश नोटबुक. सो आवर टुडे टॉपिक इज letter writing. But before moving on to the topic, let's understand what is letter writing, what are the types of letter writing, and what is the format of letter writing. So these three questions is very important before writing a letter. So what is letter writing and why we write a letter? So a letter means a written message conveyed from one person to another person. So what is letter? Why we write a letter, student? We write a letter when we want to transfer, when we pass our message to a person who is living far away from us, through whom we can't contact in phone or through any other means of communication. So in that case, we write a letter. So a letter means a message. What is mean by letter? A letter means a message conveyed. Conveyed means pass from one person to another person through a written form is called letter. So here, if you can see, one person is there. He wants to pass a message to another person. So here he writes a letter, post in the post office, and then it's the post office, the postman deliver the letter to the given address. So here this is known as letter writing. Let's understand what are the types of letter writing. Here there are two types of letter writing. One is formal letter writing and the second one is informal letter writing. So student, what are the types of letter writing? There are two types of letter writing. One is formal letter writing and the another is informal letter writing. So what is the difference between these two? Let's see. Formal letter writing. Student, in your left side, see the formal letter writing. Formal letter writing means the letter written to a person like a businessman, profession, to a person whom you don't know. You are not very much attached to that person, or you are not very much close to that person. That person is unknown to you, or even that person is known to you but not very close to you. It's an official person, it's a businessman, it's in a high post. To that person, if you are writing a letter, if you are writing a letter to that person, that letter is known as formal letter. You can take an example. If you want to write a letter to an editor, so that editor is not your friends or you're not family member, so it's another person, so it's a businessman. So editor, or you can say your principal madam, or you can say to the municipal corporation or the police inspectors. So all these are a profession one. All these are a businessman. So if you are writing a letter to those person, that letter is known as formal letter. And that letter comes in very simple languages, which is very easy to understand. The another type of letter is informal letter. Informal letter means a letter written to a personal, a very personal means a very close person. You can say family members, you can say friends, you can say neighbors. So this letter to whom you write, this letter is known as informal letter. And it's a very casual one, a very familiar language you can use in that, a very emotion attachment is there. See, you cannot show your emotion attachment to a businessman, to a principal madam, or to an editor, because they are not a known person to you. But you will write a emotional, you will show your expression to the person you know. like your father, your brother, your sister, your family members, your relatives. So if you write a letter to those person, that letter is known as informal letters. I hope you have understand the meaning of why you want to write a letter. What is letter? A letter means a message which passed from one person to another in a written manner, in a written format. Letter are of two types. One is formal letter and the second one is informal letter. Formal letter. You write a formal letter to the person which you don't know, which is unknown to you. For example, businessman, professional, profession, purpose, like that. If you write a letter, that letter is known as formal letter. And in that letter, you use a very simple language. Informal letter means a letter written to a known person, to the person whom you know very well. For example, your mom, your dad, your brother, sister, family members, relatives, neighbors, this all person you know. So if you write a letter to those person, that letter is known as informal letter. And that letter, that languages is very casual one, very normal one, as well as emotion attachment is there in that letter. So I hope you understand the two types of letter. And the third question arises in your mind is format. The format is very important. To write a letter, you should know what is the format of writing a letter. A letter should be written in a block format. Which format? Block format. In the formal letter, student, first we will see in the formal letter, there are 8 steps are there. In the formal letter, first one is the sender detail. What is the meaning of sender detail? Sender detail means the one who is writing a letter is the sender. So his detail, his whole name, his address will come. Second, date will come. And you will not write date like this way, 26-9-2020. No, the date should be written in the format which is shown in your screen. See how it is written, 26th January 2020. So this is your second step. Third step is receiver detail. Receiver detail means the one to the one whom you are writing a letter. Aap jisko letter likh rahe ho, to that person detail you have to write in that letter. I am giving you this format is a formal letter. Again, I am telling you this format is a formal letter. Yes. The receiver name and address will come. After that, subject will come. What is the subject? Subject should be very short and clear. Why it is written? To understand that what is there in the letter. Once the subject is read, once the person will read the subject, he will understand what is the letter contain. Ye letter kiske liye likha hua hai. So subject is main, informal letter. Salutation means giving respect to the person. You can write respected sir, madam, because you don't know that person. So for that you will write that. That is known as salutation. Then comes the body of the letter. Student, this is the very important. The body of the letter is divided into 3 parts. Body of the letter is divided into 3 parts. The first part is introduction. The second part is main content. And the third part is summary. So here, the first part, introduction. In the introduction, you will write what is the purpose you are writing. For what purpose you are writing a letter. That will come in that introduction part. The main content means what the problem you are facing or what exactly it's going on. That content you will write in the main content. And summary here means the closing part. You just look forward to us. Kindly just have a notice. Like that is a summary of this. So the body of the letter is divided into 3 part. Then after body will come complimentary clause. Complimentary clause means ending. So here in the formal letter, you don't know that person, so you have to show that you are very faithful to that person. Faithful means aap uske prati imandar ho. You can write truly, you can write sincerely, you can write, means this shows that you are very genuine to that person. You are very faithful to that person. That is known as complimentary clause. And the last one, you can write your name and your signature. So this is the format of formal letter. Formal letter. Let's see in detail one. See, it's the image flashed on your mobile phone is a block format. Which format it is? The letter is written in a block format. Format means on the left hand side only you have to write. Nothing will come in the right hand side. Can you see, children? Everything is come on the left hand side. So this is a format of formal letter. First will come a address. As I said, you sender address, the one who is writing the letter, that address, name and address will come on the top. Second, what is there? Date. I said you can write in this format 14 June 2020, whatever date is there you have to write it down. Then leave one line. Then the receiver address, receiver to whom you are writing a letter. So for example, one example I have taken, we are writing a letter to the editor. So what, how I have written to, first you have written down to that the editor, and address means you have to write the address of that editor. For example, Times of India, Mumbai 400079, like that any address you can write. So three came. First your sender address, sender address, then date, then receiver address. After that comes subject. So subject is already will be given in your topic. In a formal letter, subject will already be given. So you can start writing the subject, and whatever subject is there, subject should be short and precise, which is very easy to understand. After subject will come a salutation. Salutation means you can write respected sir, your madam, because you don't know that person. So that will come salutation. After salutation, what I said, you come the body of the letter. So body of the letter divided into three part. First is introduction, second is main content, and the third one is summary. So here you can start a letter to, if you are writing an editor, I would like to draw your attention, like that. If you start, you can start. After that body of the letter, what comes, student? Complimentary clause. So what will be the complimentary clause? See how it is written, your sincerely. You can write your faithfully, your truly. That would be a complimentary clause. And at the end, your name and your signature. So this is the format of formal letter. Student, I want you to write it down, this format, in your notebook, in the grammar part. So this format of formal letter, you have to draw and write it in your English notebook. First of all, you have to write what is letter, which are the two types of letter, and the format of formal letter. Now let's move on to the format of informal letter. Student, this is a format of informal letter. I said you, informal letters are written to the person whom you know very well, jisko aap acche se jante ho. To that person, if you are writing a letter, the format is this. In this format, something is not there which is there in the formal letter. For example, first the address will come, the sender address. Means jo letter likh raha hai, the one who is writing the letter, his address, name and address will come on the top, on the left hand side. Then date will come as it is. But here receiver address will not come. Why? Because the person to whom you are writing a letter, you know that person. That's why no receiver address will be there in the informal letter. In the formal letter, you have to write receiver address. But in the informal letter, you don't have to write any receiver address. Is it clear, student? The difference you understand? Dono mein kya difference hai, samajh mein aaya? In the formal letter, you have to write the receiver address. But in the informal letter, you don't have to write the receiver address. Directly you have to write the sender address. Sender address means the one who is writing the letter. Then the date will come, and directly salutation will come. Here no subject will come, because you know that person, and whatever secret, casual or emotion attached will be, directly you will write in the main letter. There will be no subject in this. Directly salutation will come. Dear father, dear brother, dear your friend name, anything, you can start with a dear. And then you can start your, this can be come in the formal, informal letter. I am fine here and hope you will be fine there. This will be the main line for starting any informal letter. Student, remember, koi bhi informal letter start karne se pehle, this line is must. this line you have to write it down. Which line? I am fine here and hope you also be fine there. And then whatever is their main content, topic is there, then you write that topic. And how you will end? Give my regards to all the family members. Means give my convey, show my love to give to all the members. And here complimentary close you will write. Your lovingly. Lovingly means because you are known to that person. So you will write your lovingly son, your lovingly daughter, whatever is there. You will write that, and at the end you will write your name. So this is the format of informal letter. Student, in the formal letter, address, sender address, date, receiver address, subject, salutation, body of the letter, complimentary clause, and then your name and signature. So this is the format of formal letter. Here in the informal letter, you will write sender address, date, complimentary clause, body of the letter, salutation, body of the letter, complimentary clause, and your name. So in the formal letter, 8 step is there, and in the informal letter, 6 steps is there. Understand? Again I repeat, in the formal letter, 8 step is there, 8 main points are there. And in the informal letter, 6 main points are there. So while writing a letter, these 2 things you have to remember in your mind, which is very important. Now let's have one example, one whole letter writing, how you'll write a letter. One example I'll show you. So here the topic is, write a letter to the editor of the newspaper. So to the editor of the newspaper means editor ko likh rahe, so that person you don't know, means this letter is a formal letter about the recklessness of drivers on the Kolkata road. So the driver who are driving very harshly, very badly, so for that you are writing a complaint letter to the editor, to the newspaper. So how you will write? See here you can first will come sender address. See, the left hand side I have given the topic, sender address, date, receiver, subject, salutation, body. That is just to show you, you don't have to write that thing. You just have to write the letter in this format. How I have written, everything comes on the left hand side, nothing will come in the right hand side. So first will come sender address. For example, sender address, whatever is there, 2298 NS Road, Naktakala, Kolkata. So the address should be short, okay. Now after that, leave one line and write the date. I said your date should be in this format, 22, like that you have to write the date. After that, the receiver address. Receiver to whom you are writing the letter? On the top only we have read, editor. So we are writing the letter to the editor. So here the editor, to you can write on the top, to the editor, the Times of any newspaper you will write. The Times of India, you can Midday, you can Now Bharat Times, anything. The Times of India, New Delhi. After that, what is the subject? So here on the top I said you, subject will be there in the letter topic itself. Aapke letter ke topic mein hi aapko subject milega. So what was the subject? The restlessness of the driver on the Kolkata road. Means here the problem. So the problem of restlessness driving in the city or on the Kolkata road, you will write that also, no problem. So subject will come. Subject should be, I said you, short and precise. And it, the topic you will get in the letter itself. After that, salutation. So salutation you can write, respected sir, because you don't know that person. And after that, how? Then will come the body of the letter. I said your body of the letter should be divided into 3 parts. First will be, what will be there? Your introduction of the topic. Second, the main content. And the last one is, will be the summary. So how I have written, see, the first introduction. Introduction means why you're writing the letter. I would like to draw the attention of the government and the people to the problem of restless driving on Kolkata road through your esteem daily. So here I am telling that I've been drawing your attention. Main aapka dhyan apne taraf aakarshit kar raha hu, that we am drawing that to a problem which the Kolkata people is been facing.
and please write this in your newspaper. That was the first introduction I had given you. But what exactly the problem facing, that we will write in the main content. So here see, main content again start down. Everything for starting a new paragraph, you don't have to leave the line. Don't leave the line. See, I have noticed with grave concern that vehicle on city roads are becoming dangerously restless these days. There are rules against restless driving, but rules fail to save human life. When we fail to show concern for our fellow being, time is surely precious, but people's life is priceless. So it is showing that people, the drivers, they are driving the vehicle very harshly, and because of that the people's lives are in danger. There are rules are there, but no one is following the rules, and rules are very important than the human lives. So like that is given. There is an unhealthy competitor among buses and other vehicles on the road to overtake one another. Pedestrians fall victims to this mindless competition. Such practice cannot be stopped merely by implementing rules. Passengers as well as the pedestrian must take a stand against this. The collective protection of the passengers against such restless driving will put a check on the driver. So here you have mentioned the problem, what is happening. So I am telling to the newspaper to highlight those news in your newspaper so that the people will come to know and they will stop doing all this thing. After that complimentary close, I said you are truly, you are faithfully, you are sincerely, you can write like that way, and then your name or signature. So this is the exact format of a formal letter. How to write a formal letter? This is the exact format. You have to copy it down in your notebook. Here, write a letter to your friend accepting. Now friend, if you are writing a letter to the friend, means you are knowing that person. Means this letter is an informal letter. Informal. In the informal letter, 6 steps is there. I said you in the formal letter, count it down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In a formal letter, 8 step is there. In an informal letter, only 6 step is there. First one will come. You are writing a letter to your friend who has invited in your birthday. You are accepting his invitation and you are writing a letter to your friend. So first sender address, you write your address. Then date will come. In this format you have to write it. Salutation, you will write dear friend Asin or dear friend you will write. Body of the letter, I said you will write a body, should be in the 3 format. Thank you very much for inviting me to your birthday party. Now very casual, very formally, very emotional wordings you will use in this letter. I will certainly came for the party. This will be a nice opportunity to meet our other friends. I will bring my little brother with me. He says that he loved to come. I look forward to the party. So this is the body of the letter which you have written. Complimentary close, your loving friend you can write, or your affectionately you can write, and down you will write your name. So this is the format of informal letter. So today we have learned how to write a letter and which are the types of letter. So there are 2 types of letter, formal and informal. So in the formal letter there are 8 steps are there. In informal letter there are 6 steps are there. Both I had explained you with one example. Student, I hope that you have understand how to write a letter. It's not easy to understand in one video. I want you to practice this at home. And for that I will give you home assignment, one letter to write as a practice. I will give you right now. So for your homework, I will give you, this is a topic. Write a letter to the editor of the newspaper on the issue of the bad condition of the road in your locality. So this is the editor letter, means you know which type of letter is this. Come on student, tell me which type of letter is this. Yes, this is a formal letter. A letter you will write to an editor. So this contains 8 steps. You have to write this homework as well as all the other 2 which is shown as an example. That also you have to write in your notebook, plus this homework. You have to write it down and send me on my personal number today before 6 p.m. If you have any doubt, If you have any queries, how to write, how to, again, if you want me to explain, you can WhatsApp me on my personal number. Student, I hope you have understand it. Just practice this. Only practice can make you to write the letter perfect. You must have heard the thought, practice makes man perfect. So to write a perfect letter, you need a practice. So practice is must. So do practice of different topics, and this you just WhatsApp me on my personal number. Thank you for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe.